Hello students, in the last lecture we have discussed that how to show the psychometric processes okay over TS diagram. Okay, so in this lecture I am going to talk about what is the concept of dew point temperature of air. Okay, so in case you have not seen my last lecture, then it is over here. Okay, this is the link, because without understanding that concept, that how to show the psychometric processes on TS diagram, this lecture will be difficult to understand. Okay, and in case you know all those things, then it's okay, you can proceed with my this lecture. So this is the TS diagram. Imagine that air is unsaturated, okay, and dry bulb temperature of air is 42 degree centigrade. This number is fictitious number, just to make you understand. Okay, and we know this thing, that in case air is unsaturated, then the vapor pressure of air will be lesser than the saturation pressure of corresponding dry bulb temperature. Okay, so imagine that the vapor pressure in air is equals to 0.0662 bar, and the saturation temperature of this pressure is 38 degree centigrade, which I have found in steam tables. So the TS diagram of vapor will be, vapor is reaching the boiling point, changing the phase, and ultimately superheating to this dry bulb temperature. Okay, now by applying corresponding arrangements, I am lowering the temperature of air. Suppose it is 42 degree centigrade and I am lowering it to 40 degree centigrade by applying refrigerator or air conditioner, whatever the method is. Okay, so you can see over here that still air is unsaturated. The reason being that for 40 degree centigrade, the saturation pressure is 0.0737 bar, and this vapor pressure is still lower than the saturation pressure of the corresponding dry bulb temperature. Okay, and I am again telling you that in case vapor pressure is lower than the saturation pressure of corresponding dry bulb temperature, then it is unsaturated air. Now suppose again I am reducing this temperature from 40 degree centigrade to 38 degree centigrade. Okay, you can see 38 degree centigrade is the saturation temperature of the vapor pressure. Okay, so in case still I am reducing the temperature to 38 degree centigrade, now what is happening? Air is saturated, because for 38 degree centigrade the vapor pressure is matching with the saturation pressure of 38 degree centigrade. Okay, so I have lowered the temperature to that much level so that the vapor pressure in air equalizes the saturation pressure of that lower temperature. Okay, so this temperature is what the dew point temperature. The reason being, because in case I am reducing the air's temperature below this temperature, even a minute decrement in the temperature will lead to what? You can see over here, suppose I have lowered the temperature to 36 degree centigrade. So for 36 degree centigrade, the saturation pressure is 0.0593 bar. Okay, and air had the vapor pressure of 0.0662 bar. Okay, so 0.0593 bar is lower than this vapor pressure, so definitely some amount of water has to be rejected by air, because the vapor pressure has to be lowered by this time. Okay, earlier the vapor pressure and saturation pressure were same for this temperature. Lowering the temperature to more level, so you can see the vapor pressure is lesser, and initially the vapor pressure in air was 0.062 bar. For reducing the vapor pressure to this much level, what will happen? Some amount of water has to be rejected by air in order to maintain this lower pressure. Okay, so this is the concept of dew point temperature. So the definition will be, if the temperature of unsaturated air is dropped down to such a level so that it equalizes the saturation temperature of corresponding vapor pressure, then it is called as dew point temperature. Okay, even a minute drop in temperature below DPT will lead to condensation of water vapor from air with calculated amount. Okay, this is what the concept of dew point temperature. And this is what happens in early morning. You would have seen that over the grass leaves, okay, in the morning over the grass leaves you would have seen very fine droplets of water. The reason being that overnight what happens, the temperature slowly falls, and ultimately the temperature falls below the saturation temperature of corresponding vapor pressure. So in case it falls below that value, then some amount of water is rejected by air, so that is collected over the leaves of grass. Similarly, for the case of air conditioner also, you would have seen that water is dropping. When air conditioner is working, then water is dropping and it has to be dumped by proper arrangements. Okay, from air conditioner, the evaporator part, the water drops. The reason being that the evaporator coil of the AC has the temperature below the dew point temperature of air. So I already told the entire science behind that. So in case the temperature drops below dew point temperature, the air has to reject some amount of water, so some amount of water condenses, and that is what comes out from the evaporator coil of the air conditioner. So hope you would have understood the concept of dew point temperature. Thank you.